Hi, let's talk about the accessory organs that serve the foregut. The accessory organs that serve the foregut consist of the liver, gallbladder, and the pancreas. The liver secretes bile. The gallbladder stores the bile that is then conducted down to meet up with the main duct of the pancreas, which is secreting pancreatic juice, through the major duodenal papilla into the second part of the duodenum there. So chyme is meeting up with secretions of the liver and the pancreas. Now the liver is the body's largest gland. Its functions are varied. It secretes, as you know, bile salts. It's important for the metabolism of carbohydrates and lipids and proteins. It's going to help us to process bioactive substances such as pharmaceuticals and toxins, etc. It's important in serving the cardiovascular system for helping to filter out defunct red blood cells and then secrete bilirubin, which is the byproduct of that process. And it's also important for storing glycogen, which is one of the easy forms of storing glucose for the body. Now, here we're looking at the visceral surface, which is the inferior surface of the liver. The other surface would be the diaphragmatic, or the superior surface of the liver. And that visceral surface of the liver allows us to get a good look at the anatomical lobes of the liver. Now, anatomically, there are four lobes of the liver. There are two major lobes, which consist of the right lobe, which you can see there, and the left lobe, which we can see there, as well as a more posteriorly oriented caudate lobe and a more anteriorly oriented quadrate lobe. So anatomically, we have the right, the left, the caudate, and the quadrate lobes. Now functionally, there are really only two lobes because the caudate and the quadrate lobes are contiguous with the left lobe of the liver. So functionally, we have left and right lobes to the liver. Here we can also see associated with the liver, the gallbladder. And adjacent to the gallbladder, we have the hilum of the liver, which we refer to as the porta hepatis. And that porta hepatis is an important region where we're transmitting three important bits of vasculature. So there's the bile duct, which is a part of the biliary tree. There's also the hepatic artery proper that's going to branch into right and left hepatic branches to serve the liver with blood. And then the hepatic portal vein, which is going to conduct relatively deoxygenated blood and a ton of nutrients from the gastrointestinal tract up to the liver for processing. We can see from this schema that the liver is more superiorly oriented. It's largely found in that right upper quadrant of the abdominal cavity. And the bile from the liver is conducted through hepatic ducts. So we have a right and a left hepatic duct that merge into the common hepatic duct. So bile can then be transmitted down through the common hepatic duct and down through the cystic duct where it's stored in the gallbladder. Bile can then move from either the gallbladder or the liver, so either from the common hepatic duct or that cystic hepatic duct, through the common bile duct, or just the bile duct, down posterior to the pyloric part and the head of the pancreas, where it meets up with the accessory duct of the pancreas. And then there's this hepatopancreatic ampulla, which is a dilation of those common ducts. And then materials are secreted through the major duodenal papilla. So the biliary tree consists of right and left hepatic ducts that join to form the common hepatic duct. that joins with the cystic duct from the gallbladder to form the common bile duct, or just the bile duct, that then joins up with the main pancreatic duct through the hepatopancreatic ampulla, through the major duodenal papilla, into the second part of the duodenum. The pancreas is the second major accessory gland or accessory organ of the foregut. The pancreas has dual function. It's both an endocrine and an exocrine gland. As an endocrine gland, about 1% of the glandular tissue consists of pancreatic islets that are responsible for regulating the concentration of blood glucose. The remainder, or the 99% of the pancreas, which is exocrine, is secreting pancreatic juice, which is really a complex association of water and salts and bicarbonate ions and various digestive enzymes, including pancreatic amylases, which digest starch, trypsin, chymotrypsin, etc., which break down peptides, pancreatic lipase for helping to break down triglycerides and other fatty acids, and ribonucleases and deoxyribonucleases for breaking down nucleic acids. Now, the pancreas has several parts to it. There's the tail of the pancreas that's in close association with the spleen here. And that tail is contiguous with a body. And then the body then goes through the neck into the head of the pancreas. And then there's an extension of the pancreas known as the uncinate process that associates with that third part of the duodenum. Now, throughout the pancreas, or throughout the length of the pancreas, there's the main pancreatic duct. There can also be an accessory pancreatic duct. The main pancreatic duct meets up with the biliary tree through the hepatopancreatic ampulla and through the major duodenal papilla into the second part of the duodenum. The accessory pancreatic duct travels through the minor duodenal papilla, which is usually proximal to the major duodenal papilla, that also secretes into the second part of the duodenum.